Hi everybody, it's that time of the year when you'll be preparing for your exams and hopefully studying very hard. And just a few last minute tips, things that we have spoken about, but just to consolidate all those ideas and thoughts in this video. When you're preparing for the SBR exam, please remember that it's very, very important to focus on the theory elements. There is a lot of explanation that is required in this exam. What that means is it's not only about learning the knowledge and rewriting that, it's about applying that into the scenario, applying it into that question, and only talking about that relevant knowledge which applies to that particular question. One of the key principles in the SBR exam is to make sure that you don't overrun time, because historically people have they take more time than allocated for the exam. The exam is 3 hours 15 minutes. It's approximately 2 minutes per mark. So make sure that each question that you're spending, you know that it's 1.95 minutes or approximately 2 minutes per mark. So if it's a 30 mark question, you're not spending more than 60 minutes on that. Whereby if it's a 20 mark question, you're not spending more than 40 minutes of that. Make sure you practice this during your studying as well, because only if you can practice it during those days will you be able to implement that in the exam. Why am I starting with these points rather than the technical aspects? Because historically I've seen these things are more important than sometimes even knowing one standard or not the other. The other thing I would say is make sure you don't panic in the exam. There will be things around 8 to 10 marks that you might not have seen before that will be written in a different way. They might put in some elements which will throw you off, which might not be the most core areas that you would have studied. But it's more important to just relax, because it doesn't matter if you don't know everything. It's not about knowing everything of all the questions. It's knowing most of it. As long as you can do majority of it, that's what really matters. So the key bit is to keep your cool, not getting stressed in the exam, not panicking by looking at things you don't know. It's like that saying, you know, looking at the glass half empty or half full. Of course, please try to think about it as half full rather than empty. Don't look at the things you don't know. Think about all the things, all the 70 or 80% of the exam that you can do very well. In terms of question specifics, remember question one is focused mainly on consolidation with other elements also. We won't get into too much detail. We will have this video for very, very long and you'll probably switch it off. So we'll keep it very short and sweet. The question one was on consolidation. Make sure you practice all the kinds of questions we did, whether it be cash flows, income statement styles, balance sheets, as well as the foreign subsidiaries. For question two is the ethics question, whereby they'll ask you some standards and something unethical will be happening there. Please, please, please make sure you don't rewrite those ethical principles of integrity, objectivity, competence, professional care, as well as behavior. You instead, what you do is you apply those principles into the question. When I say apply those principles, there will be something unethical happening in this scenario. There would be overstatement of profits. There'll be hiding of liabilities. There'll be breaching your covenants, but you'll be trying to hide that information. There'll be cases of intimidating the accountant and the general stresses that somebody faces and the reasons why they might be unethical. So make sure you address that. Question three and four will focus on three things. So two questions, but they'll focus on three things. There were 25 marks each. They'll focus first on accounting standards, which we would have studied through FR as well as the SBR elements. It's very bad practice to just look at a few accounting standards, guys, because there isn't a really trend. There can be some more important standards than the others, but at least do the summary of each of the standards so that you can start or answer any question. So first will be accounting standards. The second will be about current issues, things that are could be new, certain exposure drafts, practice statements, particularly focused a little bit on debt versus equity, materiality statements we spoke about, as well as the developments in sustainability reporting. Make sure you can look into these topics. The final element was on investor analysis, whereby they focused on the criticism, analyzing the accounts, some ratios they might tell you to impact the return on capital employed, earnings before interest, tax and depreciation, the EBITDA, the return on equity, the asset turnover, the gearing ratios. They can give you some information and tell you to comment on the impact on these ratios. They can ask you to critically analyze certain elements of financial statements of accounting standards, specifically whereby there are choices available to the users. So make sure you do all of these elements. It's very important, like I said, to stay calm and relaxed. I don't sound very calm and relaxed now, but the idea is for you to be calm and relaxed in the exam, something like that. And wish you all the very best. Do really well. See you all smiling on the exam day. Good luck.